like you. You seem like a very, very intelligent man.
You're doing this just to kill a couple. You can do one of what's in stuff.
So obviously you're smarter than me, but does that mean you're reserved?
Albert Einstein's IQ was 164.
Hello, everybody. The KingSource is back with episode 11, or chapter 11, something like that better, of our series where every team stands. Now we're starting the NL East with the Atlanta Braves. First, subscribe to the channel, like the videos, watch them on the video. It really helps out the metrics on my channel and all the channels. Now, let's start with the Braves rotation, which is one of the better ones in baseball if they actually perform. That's a big if, because there are injury woes here. Start with Max Fried, who's actually in the last year of his contract and wants out. He's their lone left-hand pitcher in this rotation. The lone guy that gives them that 1-2 punch of righty-lefty like the Yankees have. Cerdone and Cole, which is the best in the game there. The Braves could have an okay one here with Soroka and Fried, or even Morton and Fried, Anderson and Fried. The four right-handed pitchers are all about the same quality. This is one of the better rotations of baseball, and a few 1 through 5 where they're going to give you a chance to win. I rank the Braves at the number 5 rotation of baseball, and because of the depth they have here. Now, you do see a change in the closer. Jansen's gone. They have A.J. Minter in there. He led them in saves outside of Jansen last year. They also have Racio Iglesias and Will Smith. That's a good 1-2-3 punch at the back of that bullpen. Very good. This Braves team, there's reason they came back on that division. That pitching is there. It's there. Okay? It's there. Now, some people complained about not having numbers by the rotation, so I'm going to put them on for this one. Tell me what you think if you want. I don't really care either way. It doesn't change it to me. But some people wanted it, so I did it. Looking at their lineup, and one thing I got to point out here, big-time change in shortstop. Now batting ninth from last year was second. But look at the catcher. Now, I have to point something out here. Sean Murphy batted 250 last year, and his career batting average is around 258. Travis d'Arnaud batted 268 and has a career batting average above 270. So that's really an upgrade. They had the same amount of home runs. RBIs were 5 apart. D'Arnaud had a higher slugging percentage and on-base percentage. By far. Is this really an upgrade? Or is this a downgrade? I'm getting a headache just thinking about this one. When I researched it today, this is bizarre. You will see lineups, by the way, where Rosario is not in them, but D'Arnaud is. Or they take Harris out, put Rosario in center field, and Ozuna out left so they can get D'Arnaud in lineups. So they do have the 10th hitter to really come in and get some hits there. But is Murphy really an upgrade over who the Braves already had? This Braves starting to not make sense, this Braves trade. Murphy might not be as good a catcher as Travis d'Arnaud. Confusing one for sure. But this offense is going to score runs. I'd put them right around that 4.8 to 4.9 runs a game. Just like last year. Okay. They have depth. They have Jordan Luplow also on their bench, another good outfielder who will get time. He bats left-handed. In the Braves park, by the way, Murphy's stats record is going to go down. That's the other thing. I think it might be a downgrade, and the trade might just be a head-scratcher once it's all said and done. They traded their star catching prospect, who might be better than Sean Murphy when all said and done, as well, speaking of the Braves. Can't remember his name. Shea Lingelers. He's now with the Athletics. We'll see how he plays out. If he plays out and succeeds with the Athletics, the Braves could look like clowns over this trade because D'Arnaud might be the better catcher. Sean Murphy is not the star catcher everybody thinks he is. When you actually compare his stats to other catchers. The Yankees got better production out of their catching, which is pathetic, than Murphy put up. Now, that was two different catchers combined, mind you. That's worth specifying. So, it's an odd one. It's an odd one when you look into the numbers and everything. But this Braves team, I would put them right around the 90 wins mark. Again, I think they'll go back a little bit. Will they win the division? I think this is the Phillies here. I think the Phillies beefed up enough that they'll take the division. But the Braves should be a wild card. I'm confident saying that. They'll probably the first wild card as well. It'll be a battle to Padres, but yeah. I still don't think the Padres have gotten over the hump to catch the Dodgers, but it'll be close. Because of the back end of that Padres rotation is just not there anymore. It's gone. But this is a pretty good Braves team. One of the more complete teams around baseball. There is a big hole at shortstop unless Vaughn Grissom does play well enough. to fill that. And what would he have to do that? We're probably talking a 260 plus batting average, 20 plus home runs, and 60 plus RBIs, which isn't out of the realm of possibilities for Vaughn Grissom. Okay, I'm going to go over here to ESPN, and we're going to go ahead and pull up his stats. I want to see kind of historically what he has done, what he projects out as, and the way you project it out is you calculate the games by the numbers, and you add the numbers together and say what would it have been if he'd played 150 games. So he's a very high average hitter. That's the first thing I'm saying. Played 41 games, about a 291. In those 41 games, he had 5 home runs. 41 times 3 is 123. So you can easily say if he could play 150 games, he could get to 20 home runs. 18 ribbies. Again, you can easily say he could get to 60 RBIs if he plays 150 games. So it's definitely possible. And actually should be easy for him to step in and fill that void, and that might be why they didn't go hard after another free agent shortstop, which I do not blame them one bit on. So, this has been the King Source taking a look at the Braves for you. I hope you enjoyed it. Good team. Have a great day, everybody.